Hello, it's us, Panic, and I'm Krista. Welcome back to another Playdate update. This one will be pretty quick. It's focused on Playdate development, making and sharing Playdate games, so there won't be any huge announcements. But there's still a tiny bit of good news at the start. Since we last spoke, we were so thrilled to finally open up Playdate pre-orders back in July of last year. The response was incredible. If you pre-ordered a Playdate at any point, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for showing us that Playdate is something you're excited about. Then, late last year, we worked nonstop to overcome a battery-related challenge. But we're happy to report that our factory and suppliers in Malaysia have been super helpful in their work to catch up. And if you haven't ordered a Playdate yet, please don't worry. We're going to make as many as we can, limited only by hard-to-find parts. So the sooner you order, the sooner you'll get yours. Now, I'll turn it over to Panic co-founder, Cabel Sasser.
Hey friends, I'm Cabel. Sorry about the mustache. And yes, that pre-order day was well beyond our expectations, and it was honestly so much fun. And we just want to say thanks to everyone who was a part of that day, and honestly every day since. Now, I know we can't do this update without answering one big question: when will you get your Playdate? First of all, the group estimate that you got in your latest owner's update email still holds. If anything changes there, we will let you know. And here's some good news. The first batch of Group 1 Playdates are actually shipping today. Now, because units will be shipped in small batches, it's going to take a while to send out all of Group 1, but we'll be reaching out to you soon about your expected delivery date. That means things are rolling. And remember that Playdate Game Season 1 starts just for you when you set up your Playdate. So no matter when you get it, you won't be missing out on anything. Now, I'm personally looking forward to seeing what game developers everywhere make for the Playdate, because that is always mind-blowing for us. So let's talk a little bit about Playdate's SDK, the software development kit. If you didn't hear, we recently released the SDK for free, and it's a feature-packed code-level development environment for Mac, Linux, and PC. This is for people who already know their way around game development a little bit, but it's still as friendly and welcoming as we could make it. The SDK has APIs for Lua, which is a cleaner, less overwhelming scripting language, or C, which is a classic lower-level procedural programming language. It's better for performance. It includes the Playdate Simulator, which is an app for your Mac, PC, or Linux box that lets you preview your game on your computer as you develop it. A tool called Caps for making fonts, tons of documentation, example code, sample projects. There's even a developer forum where you can ask questions and share work with other developers. So that's the Playdate SDK, and I would love for you to check it out if you have even the slightest interest in making things for the Playdate. It's free to download and use, and it's available at play.date/dev. Now, the best thing about making Playdate games, in my opinion, is that you can sideload those games directly onto your system and play them without going through us. So here's a bit more news. Since we know that developers are gonna wanna sell their games and people are gonna wanna buy them, so we've started work on Catalog, a brand new Playdate app where you'll be able to easily buy curated games directly on your Playdate or find some amazing games being sold elsewhere. We'll keep you posted about Catalog when we have something more to talk about there. And finally, wouldn't it be great if you could mirror your Playdate screen to your computer screen in real time? Maybe you want to stream your Playdate to Twitch, or use a keyboard or adaptive controllers to control the Playdate more accessibly. Or maybe you just want a giant screen for your Playdate. And that's why we created the free Playdate Mirror tool for Mac, PC, and Linux. Plug in your Playdate to your computer and Mirror will automatically reflect whatever's happening on screen. You can keep using your Playdate's controls or use your computer keyboard. We made a quick little tutorial video about Playdate Mirror, and the link is in the description below. And like Arissa mentioned in our first Playdate update, our goal is that everyone can make a game for the Playdate, which is why we recently released Playdate Pulp, a browser-based game-making tool. It's totally blown us away. It's super energizing. And so we wanted to bring Pulp creator Shaun Inman here to tell you a little bit more about it. Here's Shaun. Nice to see you.
Hey everyone, I'm Shaun, the developer behind Playdate Pulp, which is free to use and available now. Many of us at Panic were really impressed by Bitsy, a browser-based game maker with cool limitations created by Adam Ledoux. Bitsy lets you easily create narrative adventure games without having to write any code. We wanted to create a Playdate tool similar to Bitsy, so you can make Playdate games as easily as Bitsy lets you make non-Playdate games. So I worked with designer Nevin Mergen to create Pulp and tailored it to the Playdate's unique black and white screen. Compared to the Playdate SDK, which is a robust development environment for more experienced programmers, Pulp is a relatively simple tool. And I think that simplicity and Pulp's constraints will make game development that much more accessible to everyone. We've already been really surprised by some of the cool things people have done with Pulp, despite its constraints. You can create tiny animated tiles and arrange them into rooms. Rooms can be connected into a world where the player can talk with sprites and collect items, all without any programming. But you also have access to a simple, terse but powerful language called PulpScript that allows you to expand upon Pulp's basic interactions. It even has a fairly full-featured music and sound editor, so you can create a cool little game with a look and sound all its own. And the best part is, you can export your Pulp game to a PDX file and play it on your Playdate. Remember, that PDX file is yours. Share it with your friends who can play it on their Playdate. They can even play it on their computer for free using the Playdate simulator, which is included in the SDK. Post it or sell it to sites like Itch, you own it, and you can make and play Pulp games even if you don't have a Playdate yet. It really is a tool for everyone. So I think people who are brand new to game development or who just have an idea for a cool story to tell are going to have a lot of fun with Pulp. Thanks for checking it out.
We're really glad to get this chance to recap our developer tools for you. And as always, we can't wait for you to get your Playdate. And we'll keep working nonstop until you do. Oh, and one last little thing. As people start to get their devices, we're excited to tell you about this bonus companion created for season one, the Playdate Podcast. I've had so much fun talking with developers, designers, and the team behind Playdate, and we're really excited to share their stories with you. The first episode, The Story of Playdate, is available now, so I hope you'll give it a listen and subscribe. And even if you don't get your Playdate right away, the podcast will be there waiting for you. Thank you so much for watching this update, and keep an eye on the website as well as at Playdate on Twitter for more news and information soon. Bye for now.